Do you know what is the principle behind the microscope and what are different type of microscope available now? Or the basic principle, what was working and still it is working? So in this video, I am going to talk about the microscope and very basic thing about this. And this will help for the beginners or the school student who have learned about microscope in their textbook and now they are going to use this in their lab practical session. So let's start. So as we all know that microscope is an instrument which is used to see small molecules or objects which we can't see with our naked eyes, right? And what is microscopy? Microscopy is a science in which we use the instrument microscope to see the small object, right? So now let's move to the thing that how you will look how the things look when you see this object or the thing in the microscope. So this is the image of the mosquito when it has been viewed with the microscope. As you can see how zoom out or the quality of the image you will get. You will never see such type of image with your naked eyes, that the blood is filled in the abdomen of the mosquito and how the skin is, it's very clear that the skin is also very clear. So this type of magnified view only we can get with the microscope. So microscope help to zoom out the things in a better way. Now what are types of microscope? For this, to make simple, in this video I have categorized the type of microscope in four type. First is a simple light microscope. Another is fluorescence microscope. The third one I have kept confocal microscope, which is advanced version of the fluorescence microscope, and the scanning microscope. In this video, I am going to focus only on the simple light microscope, and other microscope I'll discuss in my next video. So let's move with the simple light microscope. So basically there are two types of the simple light microscope. One is simple microscope, which is called magnifier. It has only one lens. And another is compound microscope, which I will talk you immediately after this. So friends, you have seen this in your class, or even you might have in your home also. And the jewelry maker or the watchmaker also keep there to see the fine details of the jewelry or even the element of the watch. And for medical store also, in medical store also people used to keep this to read the small fronts. So you might have seen this. This will give you the less magnified image because there is only one lens. The advance of this is the compound microscope, where there is multiple lenses, eyepiece and the objective, which is closer to the object, and eyepiece which is closer to the eye, which I will talk to in this thing in the next slide. So and this is used in the laboratory also, right? In the all laboratory you will see this type of the microscope available, where it is used for the histology to see the cellular structure in relatively broader perspective. This will definitely give you the higher magnification than this, because they are two lenses are used, eyepiece and the objective. And if you want to see further higher magnification, there are different objectives available for different purposes. The types of objective I have discussed in my next video. So now coming to the principle of simple microscope. What is the principle of simple microscope? You might have read this in your school in the physics, that how the lens work. So we all know that in the lens there is a focus point, there is a center point, right? So this is the convex lens which is used in the simple magnifying glass, right? Where now suppose this is one object AB, right? And the ray like AO, which is parallel to the principal axis, will cross through the convex lens and it will refract it and focus at the F. Another line light which you pass from the AC, which will cross to the center, and it will be AY. These two refracted rays will intersect at some point, which this is called A dash. And the perpendicular line when you draw from A dash to principal axis is the B dash. So this is the magnified erect image, right? This is the same I have just shown with the image structure and the eye. So this will give you the same detail where what we are seeing observing here. And what is the magnification? So magnifying power of the simple microscope can be derived by this formula, where m is equal to 1 plus d by f. What is d? D is the least distance of distinct vision. Friends, we can't see any object as far as possible. The zoom or with the clarity of image, what we will see is required minimum 25 centimeter. So minimum 25 centimeter from our eye, we can see the images clearly. That is the least distinct vision. And least distance of distinct vision. And what is f? F is the focal length of the convex lens. So since it is inversely proportional, magnification inversely proportional to the focal length. So lower the focal length, you will get higher magnification, right? So maximum magnification what we can get from this type of simple microscope is 10, which means that object will appear 10 times larger by using this simple microscope. I hope you have understand this basic principle of simple microscope. Now let's move to the compound microscope. First we'll see the basic part which is there in the compound microscope. So there will be eyepiece where we keep our eyes to see the sample. Then there will be objective which will be near our specimen which we would like to see. This is the body and this is the light source which will be kept here, and this is the base which will be heavy to keep the microscope hold tightly. Now the basic principle is what? It is similar to the basic principle how the lens works. Since now there's two lenses, objective lens and the ocular lens, so there will be magnification with both lenses. So objective lens will magnify the object, and this will be the virtual magnified image made by the objective lens, right? Ocular lens will use this as an object and will finally form the magnified image towards the object. So the total magnification what will be acquired from the compound microscope will be multiplication of magnification of objective and the ocular lens. So this will be the total magnification. So now can you get the idea that how it will be better than the simple microscope? I hope this video might have helped you to understand the basic principle of microscope, how it works, and what are different microscope available. If you have liked this video, please subscribe my channel and share with your friends also. So finally, thanks for watching. Thank you so much.